and died on me.
Robert Vesco was a central player in American financial and political scandals in the 1970s. In 1971, the SEC accused Vesco of looting $200 million out of a mutual fund he controlled. And a year later, Vesco made an illegal campaign contribution to Richard Nixon, hoping that Nixon's attorney general would let him off the hook. And when he didn't, Vesco fled the country, living the rest of his life in glamorous exile in Costa Rica, Nicaragua, the Bahamas, and Cuba, where he reportedly died in 2007.
Reportedly.
When Reddington was in prison, he heard a rumor that Vesco faked his death to avoid capture.
Does he have any proof?
He sent Dembe to Havana to dig up his grave. He asked me to have the ME run the DNA on the remains he unearthed.
There was a time when the Bureau was actively hunting for Vesco, but we're not anymore. If he did fake his death, I doubt it was to avoid capture.
Reddington agrees. He thinks Vesco found the De La Cruz, a Spanish ship filled with gold that sank off the coast of Florida in the 1700s. Vesco always told him that if he found that treasure, that he would disappear forever.
Does Mr. Reddington know him?
Know him. Vesco was Reddington's mentor, until he swindled him out of every penny he had and left him high and dry in a whorehouse in Paraguay.
I like this guy already.
The last 50 years have been two truly mythic fugitives, Robert Vesco and Raymond Reddington. If one can help us get the other, I'm all for it. Wrestler, Keen, find out where the ME's at with the remains.
Before you do that, I...